Egypt is now second only to China in jailing journalists, while prison sentences for writers have almost doubled since 2014. One such writer, and the reason we're holding today's event, is the novelist Ahmed Naji. On 25th February, Ahmed was sentenced to 2 years in prison. The sentence for violating public modesty relates to the publication of excerpts from his 2014 novel, Using Life. I think today is the 83rd day of Ahmed's imprisonment. And to mark that, we are holding this event, but there are more than, I think, 25 and counting events taking place around the world. Today we're going to be reading not only from Ahmed's work, but from the work of some other writers who are at risk, and sadly one who was murdered in Egypt today.
That's not to say life in Cairo was completely miserable. There were good times to be had year round, some during our long summer and quite a few during our short winter. Such times were invariably either days off work or days without it. They say the city never sleeps. They say it bursts at the seams. The city rotates and revolves. The city branches out. The city beats. The city bleeds.
I have just been sentenced to 6 months in prison for insulting a public official. I had already decided not to attend my trial. And if there was a sentence against me, I would not appeal it. I'm now on my way to Sayyida Zainab police station to hand myself in. I'll try to explain how I arrived at this point. Well, this time, I will not play along. I just don't have the energy. I am not taking this decision lightly. Being in prison isn't easy, and I know that. In Egypt, prisoners aren't even allowed to fall. But I shouldn't complain. At least I get to see my family 2 or 3 times a month. Other political prisoners, mostly Islamists, are not allowed visits at all.
To play in the sand, to muddle the letters and scatter their names. However, the stride of the sea is bigger. My heart is small and trembles like the eyes of birds. The waves toy with my words. Its heave lengthens through my letters, teaching them how to catch a squirrel in the branches of rhymes, how to splash water over a child.